In this section, I'm going to cover how do you calculate percentages in Excel. So for example, let's say that we have $1,000 that we invested in some kind of fund. At the end of the year, let's say we made $1,200. It's hard to make that much money anymore, but let's say we did. We are going to format this as accounting dollar amounts. Now in this area here, let's say we want to calculate the percentages. So we'll format that as percentage. The idea here would be take number 2 minus number 1. So what the statement was at the end of the year minus what you invested in the beginning of the year divided by what you invested in the beginning of the year. So it would be basically 1200 minus 100 divided by 1000, or 1200 minus 1000 divided by 1000. So to express this in a formula, it would be the equal sign number 2. Actually, we have to do this in parentheses. So number 2, if you remember your basic math, minus the number 1, close parentheses, divided by the first number, and then hit enter. So notice we had a 20% profit. Again, the reason why it gave us the 20% was because I formatted it first with a percentage amount. Now if we had, for example, $4,000, and at the end of the year we had $3,800, and we want to find the percentage here, we could either do this manually again, equal, open parentheses, number 2 minus number 1, close parentheses, divided by the first number, and then hit enter. So we lost 5%. Or we could simply use the autofill feature and drag this down. Notice it's giving us an error here on the third one. That's because we don't have any numbers here. So if we had, for example, 6,000 and then 6,500, now notice we made 8%. So to format these values, and by the way, the best way to learn about this stuff is basically explore the program and see what it does and what the features are. So let's say we want to format the negative values in red here. You can select these cells and then right-click and choose Format Cells. Under Format Cells, you have all kinds of options here. So you can choose, under Number, you can pick how you want to represent the negative numbers. So for example, negative numbers, you could represent them in red or in parentheses right here. So if let's say I wanted them in parentheses, click OK. Now notice it's coming as 0 here. The reason is because I don't have those decimal points. See, if I increase the decimal points to 2 of them, then I have a 5% decrease. Now the reason, if you notice, because we tinkered with the formatting of these cells, if we want to change them into percentages, you can select those and choose percent, and it will give you the percentage change.